In the first part of this video, we have studied about materials, objects and matters. Matters means anything that occupies space and have mass. Matter means anything that has mass and occupies space is called matter. But the feeling of love, sadness or joy do not have mass and do not occupy any space, hence they are not matter. Okay, I hope you understood what is matter. But what is this matter made up of? These matters are made up of very very small pieces, and the smallest piece of matter which cannot be split further is called an atom. I already told you before that name of the smallest particle, an atom, is given by British scientist John Dalton. And the substances like iron, gold, copper, silver, whose smallest particle is an atom, are called elements. Means the atom of a particular substance is called element, and element is the primary constituents of matter. Okay, matter means anything that occupies space and have mass, and these matters are made up of atoms. Number of atoms. Matters are made up of number of atom. Means the smallest particle of any matter is called atom. Okay, and the atom of particular substance like silver, iron, copper are called elements. Atom of particular substance is called element. Element is the primary constituents of matter. Okay, and these elements, two or more elements combine together to form a compound. Means compound are made up of combination of two or more elements. Okay, I hope you understood. The substances which are formed by the combination of two or more element is called compound. For example, water, sugar, salt, etc. And the smallest particle of compound is called molecule. Okay, you can see this table here. The composition of some common compounds are given here. Like here, so many compounds. In the first column, like salt, sugar, water, vinegar. So first compound is salt. Salt, the formula of the salt is NaCl. It means salt is made from the sodium and chloride, two elements sodium and chloride combine together to form salt. Okay, now next, sugar, formula of the sugar is C6H12O6. It means sugar is made from three different elements: carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Water, formula of water is H2O. Okay, so water is made from the combination of two elements: hydrogen and oxygen. Water is made from the combination of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Okay, now see next baking soda. Baking soda, your mother might be use this baking soda for making dhokla and fermented food. So formula of baking soda is NaHCO3. Okay, and it means baking soda is made from combination of four different element, sodium, hydrogen, carbon and oxygen. Combination of sodium, hydrogen, carbon and oxygen baking soda is made up of. Next, washing soda. Formula of washing soda, Na2CO3. It means washing soda is made by the combination of sodium, carbon and oxygen element. Okay. Next, vinegar. Vinegar means acetic acid. Another name of vinegar is sirka. Generally, sirka have been used in making pickles. So, vinegar, CH3COOH. Okay, and means vinegar is made from three different element: carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Means carbon, hydrogen and oxygen combined in a definite proportion to form vinegar. Sand. Sand is made up of silicon and oxygen, two elements. Okay, there are these are the elements, and different elements combined together to form particular compound. There are about 118 different known elements present in our nature, out of which 92 elements occur naturally, while rest 26 elements have been made by man. It means 26 elements made by the scientist in laboratories. Total 118 different elements are present in our nature. Children, you can see one table is given here. The different elements, total 118 different elements are shown here. Okay, you can, children, if you think of atom like English alphabet, there are 26 alphabets in English. We can combine just 26 alphabet to make thousands of words, sentences and books even. Similarly, just imagine the number of compound that can be made by combination of 118 different elements. Means number of compounds, probably millions of compounds are formed by the combination of these 118 elements. And each molecule is different from other. For example, see here, the two atom of hydrogen combine together to form one molecule of hydrogen gas. And two atom of oxygen combine together to form one oxygen molecule, and oxygen is also a gas that we breathe. But two atom of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combine together to form water. See, two hydrogen atom combine together to form hydrogen gas. Two oxygen atom combine together to form oxygen gas. But two atom of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combine together to form water molecule, and water is liquid. You understood how different element combined together to form compound. You can see one more example here. Sodium chloride. Sodium chloride means salt that we are using in our food. Sodium is an element and chlorine is another element. Sodium, one atom of sodium combined with one atom of chlorine together, both are poisonous substances, but when they combine together we get sodium chloride molecule, that is table salt we add to our food while cooking every day. Okay, from this examples I hope you understood how different elements combine together to form compound. There are total 118 different elements, and out of these elements the compounds are formed which are present in our universe. Okay, that's all about elements and compound, children. In our next video we will study about the classification of this 118 different elements or classification of materials. Okay, until then, goodbye.